little bit windy today, so excuse me, there's a bit of dustiness, but the buildings in Granada are just absolutely stunning, aren't they, Melissa?
Beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at that.
Through the streets of Granada on the way to breakfast, and
we stopped at a crossing.
And I said something about, look, it's a shame we don't have this in Christchurch. And this lady thinks we're going, Christchurch! She goes, what were their names?
Diane and Dennis, and they're from Tauranga. We've just chatted to them for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, there's a lot of people travelling, I've got to tell you, it's pretty mad. Right, Melissa, breakfast time.
Breakfast
time. This, I think, is the best coffee we've had. What do you think?
Beautiful. Yummy.
This is the Granada Cathedral. Looks absolutely massive. And look at this. Out of the beautiful cathedral in Granada, and now we thought we'd go to a traditional tea house.
Moroccan.
Oh, Moroccan tea house, yes. They've got lots of beautiful different types of tea.
We don't know what they have.
We don't know what we're doing. Do you know what we're doing?
No, we're just going to a tea house.
Okay, well, let's go to a tea house.
With a smoke thing.
Oh, I'm going to try and have a big smoke thing, whatever that is. We're such uneducated tourists, don't we, Melissa?
You know we're
mad.
Yeah.
Just wandering through. This is a very local Muslim area. So we're going into a traditional tea house. This is really out of Melissa's comfort zone. What do you think, Melissa? Isn't it beautiful? Beautiful. Thank you. This is the little Egyptian coffee. Look at that.
Having a proper deal.
Oh, no.
Wow. What is this?
Bulgur.
Oh. What did they call it?
A hookah.
A hookah. And an Egyptian coffee and this.
Lovely. Very cool.
Oh, it's fantastic. What an experience.
I've never seen such enthusiasm.
Wow. Oh.
That's really great. I think
the cardamom coffee. It's just stunning.
Cheers.
It's been
a long trip.
Oh, here we are in a traditional tea house in Granada. It's a Muslim tea house, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we're having Egyptian coffee, which is cardamom and orange, and it's quite bitter.
Yeah.
We've got this thing called a hookah, and I've got some grape flavoured smoke thing in it. Give
very
it
nice. Oh yeah. Can you do that?
It's like a big vape. Hello, gentlemen. Hey, the tea house. Got some lovely.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Oh,
New Zealand.
Thank you.
Yeah. Morning, everybody. We're out early this morning on our way to go and see one of Granada's most spectacular sights. Traipsing up this hill on our way up to see the Alhambra. Walking into the Alhambra. Oh, Melissa, Pussycats. Look at this. Isn't this beautiful?
Imagine if this was your morning terrace, so you came and had your cup of coffee in the morning. Is that beautiful?
It's just absolutely beautiful, isn't it?
Sculpture, I hope you see it in the film. And then, like, you're overlooking the city.
That's a bit of a look around the Lumberer, and just a mind-blowing myriad of gorgeous architecture and stunning gardens. We're sitting in a beautiful cafe with a view over to the Lumberer over there. And what's happening, Melissa?
It's pouring with rain.
Come all the way up the hill in Granada to a cafe to overlook the Alhambra.
It's been pouring down with rain, so we've stopped for a few seconds and we've jumped out to take a video.
We've quickly jumped out in the cafe because it's been pissing with rain. First rain we've had in the entire trip though, eh?
Yep.
Anyway, that is the Alhambra. Just amazing. I say amazing and beautiful a lot, don't I? Do I?
150 times a day.
It's beautiful. It's amazing. The road is very, very, very slippery after the rain, but my God, look at that view. Melissa's headed back to the room. It's a little bit noisy for her, so I'm going to go into a very bustling tapas bar in here in Granada and check out what the locals are eating and drinking and take you along for the ride.
Thank you.
In this very, very noisy bar. Very noisy bar, having vermouth, trying to get some tapas. Everything's in Spanish, it's very difficult to understand. And I've just had something turned that I don't think I ordered, but there we go. It's amazing. Look how vibrant it is in here. I ordered some vermouth, which is my favourite in Spain. Absolutely delicious. And they give you a free tapa, so I got this free black rice. Never asked for it. And I've ordered a croquette. And this was €1.50. And then I've got a lovely retato, a little Spanish omelette, with some fresh anchovies on top. And that was €3. One of the most popular bars in Granada for tapas. Big platters, everyone's having a good time.
Awesome, I am in my element.
Okay, now I've ordered some jamon ham.
I'm yelling because it's very, very loud in here.
This is a beautiful, this is only 60 grams, would you believe, of jamon ham. The ham in Spain is just insane. This is acorn-fed Iberian ham. It's just delicious, especially with some vermouth. My favourite. Vermouth. Where have you been all my life? This is a spectacular drink out of Spain. It's like a very light, fruity sort of cocktail sherry. It's just so refreshing. It's very alcoholic, I have to say. They're two in a bit. I am in my absolute element in a tapas bar in Granada, heaving with people, eating at the bar, vermouth. Hard to keep up, my God. I had a wonderful guy serving me a waiter. I was talking to my Google Translate, he's just drawing me a map. It says, Spain, New Zealand. People here are wonderful, they're just so welcoming. And what's even better is, I now have a sangria.
Okay,
this is the reason why people come out and they eat in these lovely, beautiful tapas bars. I've just been in there, I've come over the bill. So I've had two vermouths, I've had a... well, they didn't charge me for the sangria, that's great. I've had a tortilla, three croquettes, and half a plate of beautiful jamon, and it was $23. $20 to come out and have three drinks and four dishes of food. And I've taken away two croquettes. Look at this. It's just... people are out everywhere in the streets. Oh, man. Got to get yourself to Granada, southern Spain sometime. It's very, very near the southern coast. It's very near Africa. So it's quite wonderful.